For those who want to download the worksheet in these next examples, go to the frugalcomputerguy.com, video tutorials, and then office spreadsheet. And down at the bottom of that page, I will have the link to download those ODS spreadsheets. Now we're going to mix the conditional and the formatting and bring it all together. So what I'm going to start with here is I'm going to click on this accounting, and I want to go into format, conditional formatting. I'm going to say if the cell value is equal to, and I'm going to use a double quote, accounting typed out, and then another double quote, the cell style, it's default, but we want to change that to, and we're going to create a new style. A lot of you people from Excel are going to see this too, because you have to create a new style, but I could choose from the blue default or the blue heading that I just had, but I'm going to select a new style, and I'm going to call this new style accounting. And to make them stand out, I'm going to give a yellow background, and I want my font to be bold. So I click OK, and I see bold yellow accounting, and I want this format to be for the whole thing, so I'm going to click on the paintbrush there and paint all of this column all the way down. There we go. And anywhere it says accounting stands out, so that's kind of handy. We can also use this to make people's age. Let's say that we want to insert or format, conditional formatting. We want everyone under 40. Let's see, if we say if we're under 40, less than 40. We want the, we're going to create a new style. And if I don't give it a title, it's just going to say untitled, and I'm going to change the background to green. We'll make it a brighter green than that, though. Alrighty. And a second condition is if it's greater than 40, less than, we want to say greater than or equal to 40, we will make our new style untitled 2, and it'll be a background gray 20%. Alrighty, by clicking OK. This one shows up green, but we still want to make the whole column instead of just this one. So I'm going to grab that format paintbrush and do the whole column. Now things stand out. Why didn't our people turn gray? Let's go back into our format. Double check that format. Conditional formatting. If it's less than or equal, we had less than, so since they were all less than, so we gotta say greater than or equal to. Now we should be good. And again, I need to copy this all the way down. Now we should be all set. And there we have the gray over 40 and green under 40. Another thing we want to check for would be blanks. If these are nothing, so I'll start with here because it's easier to copy from the top, and I'll say format, conditional formatting, and I say if the cell value is equal to nothing, I will use the accounting style. There's our accounting style, and we don't see anything because this has a value in it, but when I do the paintbrush, come all the way down, you see that the blank ones stand out as yellow. We can also do this with refer to a different cell. See here, I'm saying last name of Taylor, and I want to format this as conditional formatting, and to change things up, we're going to give it a new style, untitled 3. We're just going to change the font. Let's make them bold and italic. And we want to say if, instead of equal to the cell value, we want to say formula. Now we want to say if we're in B5, so we want to say if L5, or I think I had it equals L5 equals group space D, and we click this OK. So we can see that he is italicized, but he's not bold. Let me fix that format. Additional formatting. Actually, I'm going to just go in through here to show that we have our untitled 3, and I want to modify that. So I want to make it bold and italic. And let's also put some borders around it, some regular borders. So now we can see it. And we want this one as well. So if I copy this format over, and we're going to have a quick change with that because we need to say format conditional formatting, and formula M5, we want to change this to L. Okay, so now we got them all, and we use our little paintbrush, and we can see everyone that is in group D is now bold and italicized. We've done our ages. So we've gone a little crazy with our formatting here, but you get the idea. You might want to do a lot less, but just enough to point out the things that really matter. But this was just to demonstrate all the different ways of doing it, of using our conditional formatting.